Hello to Miss White's Year 7 class at the Genesis Christian College. My name is Damon and I made that sugar film and I'm here to answer your questions. So you're going to hear a funny voice and that's Anna who's here with me and she's going to ask your questions and then I will answer them. Let's go, Anna.
From watching your film, I understood that cutting out sugar isn't easy. So what kind of food would you cut out first and what order of removal would you recommend?
Very good question. So in terms of probably the best way to start with this whole stuff is to get rid of the sugary drinks first. So things like sports drinks like Gatorades or Powerades, things like Coke and lemonade and Fanta, things like energy drinks, those mother drinks or V drinks, they're probably the first thing to start because the science is very, very strong now on the fact that that sugar turns to fat in your liver very, very quickly and starts to cause the problem. So I'd start getting rid of that stuff. And then I guess start looking at the, you know, how much of the ice creams and the chocolates that you're having and make sure that you can still have that every now and again, but just don't have it too often because that's what's going to cause the problems.
Okay, question number two. What are some things that make it easier to give up sugar?
Okay, so the easiest way that the foods that really help are things like we know now from the science that your brain gets activated with sugary things, so it really lights up when you have something sugary. And there are other types of foods which are kind of healthy fats which also light up parts of your brain but not quite as strong as sugar, so they can help you with some of the cravings. So I often make a smoothie where at home where I'll put maybe half a banana in there, maybe a little bit of coconut cream, some water, maybe a little bit of avocado sometimes and blend that all together. So you still get a sweetness from the banana, but you're also getting those healthy fats which help you make you feel full and they also activate the brain, so it makes you kind of get rid of those sugar cravings faster. So fruit's really good if you're trying to get off sugar, like things like blueberries are fantastic. I'll often have blueberries even with some yogurt. And there's also these dried coconut crisps you can get now that are delicious, and you get ones that don't have any sugar added to them and they're really good at helping you transition off a lot of sugary foods.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how exactly did you feel when you were eating sugar compared to when you had a balanced diet?
Scale of 1 to 10. When I was having the sugar, I reckon I felt about 6 out of 10. And then when I stopped having it and I was back to my normal foods, I'm about 9, 9.5 out of 10. So it's a huge difference for me. I'm very sensitive to it. Not everyone might be as sensitive as me, but I reckon there's lots of people out there, especially children, that are very sensitive to it. So the thing is, a lot of people have never experienced what it's like to not have sugar in their diet because most of us have had it every single day of our lives since we were babies. So we've never gone with a week of not having much sugar. So I really try and suggest people to try it. Just go for a week. Say, you know what, I'm going to test it out and have very little added sugar in my diet for a week and see how you feel. See how it affects your sleep, your moods throughout the day, your ability to concentrate in class. Just give it a go and see if it's for you.
Is it still okay to have an occasional treat of sugar? And this is a really good question. What is occasional in your opinion?
So the World Health Organization, they recommend that for kids about your age, they should have no more than 4 teaspoons of added sugar a day. So really, that's not much. If you've seen the film, that's probably a couple of spoonfuls of flavored yogurt or half a glass of juice. So you've really got to be careful not to have too much. I absolutely think it's fine to have the occasional treat. There is nothing wrong with the occasional bit of sugar. The film is really about showing you that we're all having too much, and because most of us don't know where the sugar's hidden in the food. So if you want to have a little bit of chocolate, go for it. I recommend the dark chocolate because it's actually got a little bit less sugar in it and it tastes better anyway. But yeah, whatever your treat is, a little bit of ice cream, whatever it is, that's totally fine. This is not about being extreme and saying you can never have it again. It's just about being more aware of how much you're having so you can be smarter with your choices.
I noticed that you were eating dairy-free cheese. Is it important to eliminate dairy from our diet as well?
No, well actually, it's a good question. The only reason that dairy-free cheese is there is because that gentleman who's talking in the film, David Wolfe, he doesn't eat cheese. So I thought it would be unfair if I put him on a block of cheese when he doesn't eat cheese himself. Look, I think everyone's different when it comes to dairy. Some people are fine with it. There are studies that show around 75% of people in the world are lactose intolerant, which means they don't deal with dairy too well. And I think it's just about the individual case. See how you go with it. If it makes you feel a bit funny or bloated or you feel a bit lethargic when you have it, then it might not be for you. but other people are perfectly fine with it. I have a little bit every now and again, mainly in the form of like hard cheese. I'll have some hard cheese or some full-fat yogurt every now and again, but apart from that, I don't have a lot of it.
What does chicken taste like when it's covered in sugar?
Surprisingly delicious. Look, I'm not going to advocate that everyone goes out and does it, but I was actually shocked at how kind of strangely good it tasted having sweet chicken. So I'm not going to promote it, but I would never do that again. And that was a very, very hard scene. That whole day was really tough to eat the real sugar. But sadly, most of us are doing that every day. It's just that the sugar's dressed up in very colourful packets, so we don't realise it.
I have heard that any yogurt with fruit cannot be healthy because this elevates the fructose levels. Always eat non-fruit yogurt. True or false?
Well, look, sometimes some of the flavoured yogurts do have a lot of sugar added in. There's no doubt about that. And again, if you're going to have a little bit every now and again, no dramas. But what we do at home is use plain yogurt, but then add our own fruit to it. So add fresh blueberries or some cut strawberries or a little bit of banana. So you get the real fruit, not the sugary concentrated version of fruit, but you get the whole fruit with the fiber plus the yogurt. So if you are going to do that, it's fine. And we've got to remember that, you know, fruit's not a problem, especially for young kids that are active. Even though there is fructose in the fruit, it's protected by the fiber, which slows down the metabolism in your bodies so that you can deal with it very well. So we're not about fearing fruit here. We're only looking at the added sugar in foods.
Can you walk us through the food you eat on an average day, as most foods appear to have sugar in them?
Yeah, so for me, I've got used to it now, and it does get easier once you start looking out for labels and understanding what's got sugar in it. So I just try and eat real food as much as I can, because then you don't have to worry about looking at the sugar content. And real foods are all those foods that you get on the perimeter of the supermarket. So most days I would probably have like some egg for breakfast, like a boiled egg or some poached egg, maybe sometimes some bacon, sometimes some avocado with it. Sometimes I'll have some plain yogurt again with berries and a little bit of fruit and some coconut chips on top of it just to give it some flavour. Maybe with some nuts as well, like some almonds. I often snack on almonds throughout the day, or a piece of fruit with a little bit of cheese. I'll have some salad kind of things for lunch, maybe with a bit of protein like some tuna or some chicken. And then the same goes for dinner. So again, if you can just eat the majority of your foods as real food and have the occasional processed food, that's fine. But I think at the moment we've got it around the wrong way, where we're having lots of the processed foods and only every now and again are we having the vegetables or the real food. So it's just about getting that balance back again. You don't have to go extreme. It's just to try and eat real food as much as you can and you'll be fine.
This is a great question. Should we be scared about what we are eating?
Should we be good? That is a terrific question. No, absolutely. We shouldn't be scared about it, but we should be aware of it. And I think that's what's important about the film, is it's just creating education about this topic. Because I think lots of people don't understand how sugar behaves in our body. And once we have that knowledge and that information, we can then choose what we want to eat. So it's not about fearing sugar. It's just about knowing that at the moment we're having 30 to 40 teaspoons a day hidden in our foods. And we're only recommended by the World Health Organization to have about 6 for you guys, even less, about 4. So how do we get down to only having 4 a day? Because if we can do that, we're not going to see the amounts of obesity, type 2 diabetes, fatty liver disease. These growing rates of disease are going to start to slow down, especially in children, because we're going to be more aware of our food. So it's very important to do that. And early on, it can be a bit difficult because you want to go extreme and you might think, oh, sugar's dangerous and bad. But that's not the point of it. We're just trying to say, be more aware of how much you're having. It's about reducing sugar, not removing it.
Aside from water and tea, what else do you drink to give some variety in your liquid intake?
These are great,
drink has added sugar, but I didn't realise how much.
Yeah, look, the drink one's interesting. I've just got used to it now, that I just pretty much have water or fizzy water, but then we often add things to that water. So you can put mint leaves in the water, which really change the taste. You can squeeze some, a little bit of fresh lemon or lime, even a bit of orange peel in there. Sometimes we put berries in there as well, like real berries, or make ice cubes out of frozen berries and strawberries and raspberries and things like that. And you'll be surprised at how that does affect the taste of the water and just makes it a little bit less bland. And you can also do that with warming up, making hot drinks as well. So you can even use real cacao and you put that in with a bit of milk to make sort of like a hot chocolate, and maybe a bit of banana in there as well. So There's different ways of doing it. I often have a smoothie as well. That's a good way to get some energy into and drink. And that's where, you know, bananas are great. You don't need to add honey or agave or sugar to your smoothie. You can just have a bit of milk with a little bit of water, plus some blueberries and a banana. And that's a great kind of smoothie because you're still getting the fiber of the fruit. It's not like juicing where you're taking all the fiber away. When you are making a smoothie, if you just put in the same amount of fruit that you'd normally eat, for me, maybe half a banana and some berries, you can still drink that and you'll be fine.
The film said the recommended daily intake of sugar is 6 teaspoons for adults. Is this the same for kids or teenagers?
Yes, I think we've answered that before. So for adults, about 6, but teenagers is about 4 teaspoons a day. And I think for children between the ages of 8 and 12, the recommended is only 3 teaspoons of added sugar a day. So,
how can you tell what type of sugar is in your food? The labels simply say carbohydrate 22 grams and sugar 20 grams. But how do you know if this is glucose, lactose, fructose,
etc.? Yeah, this is an excellent question, and this is why we're really trying to work on a new labelling system at the moment. We've developed one that has a very clear teaspoon on the front of the packet that tells you how much added sugar and how much natural sugar is in the product, because this is a very good question. The way I do it at the moment is you really need to look at the ingredients. So instead of just looking at the readout that says sugars, then look at the ingredients and you'll be able to see if they've added these kind of sugars that we're trying to avoid. So for example, if you see milk and you see sugars 12 grams, look at the ingredients and you know there's nothing added in there, so that's going to be naturally occurring sugar called lactose, which is in the milk. But if you see a yogurt, for example, that will also have lactose in it, naturally occurring. But if you look at the ingredients, if they've added fruit juice concentrate, agave, honey, sugar, it means it's also got the added sugar in it as well that we're trying to avoid. So it does take a bit of effort. You have to look at both things, the ingredients list and the nutrition panel, to work out what's in there. But I think companies are starting to change a little bit and realizing that people want a bit more clarity. So we're going to see a bit of a change in the next few years.
I've seen some recipes that don't have sugar, but they use glucose syrup or rice malt syrup or dextrose. What's the difference and is it any better for you?
Yeah, great questions. So I think, look, the World Health Organization still considers those sugars as added sugars to food, so it's still about being kind of careful with them. But rice malt syrup, for example, doesn't have fructose in it, which is the fructose is the one we've been talking about that might be causing the major problems. But it still is a syrup, so it's still a very kind of refined sugar. So it can spike your blood sugars very quickly, which can affect your moods and even your ability to trap and hold on to weight in your body. But that said, you know, if you're having a bit of a treat or your mum's making some muffins every now and again and using rice malt syrup, absolutely fine. There won't be a drama there. Again, I think with this stuff, we just have to not be too extreme. I think we've just got to a point where we're having far too much sugar. We just have to get it down a bit. And if that means you're having the occasional dextrose or rice malt syrup or, you know, coconut sugar or any of those every now and again, totally fine.
You mentioned in the film that you get your carbohydrates from vegetables. Does this mean bread and pasta should be avoided?
Again, excellent question. It's all about the context. So for someone that was very, very overweight or obese or has type 2 diabetes, most people would suggest that they limited their amount of bread or pasta that they're having. But if you're exercising a lot, if you're active, then it's not going to be a major drama, especially for kids your age that are running out there at recess or lunch. The bit of bread and pasta, that's going to be totally fine. So it's all the relative. I cut it out after the experiment because I wanted to get back to my normal weight and get metabolically healthy on the inside very, very quickly. So that kind of worked for me. But it doesn't mean that you guys have to do it now because you are running around and burning off that energy. And everyone's different. You know, some people are very sensitive to it and others. So if there are kids that may be a bit larger and whatnot, then they might be struggling with it. So it's probably best for them to cut back on the breads and the pastas. But everyone's going to be different.
Is pasta okay if you make your own sauce rather than using the store-bought ones that have lots of sugar? This probably goes for any sauces, e.g. stir fries and dressings, like salad dressing, right?
That's right, spot on. So if you can make, if you've got the time and it's a good process, you can do it with your mum or your dad and make the sauces, it's fantastic. It's fun to do, then that's much better. You just got to realise that any time the companies make it, they're going to put sugar in there because they know it will sell more if it's got a sweeter taste, because we're all used to that sweet, but also that sugar is a preservative. So it often makes the sauce last on the shelf a bit longer, which is what they need, because they're shipping them around the country, around the world. They need their sauces to not go off. But if you're making it fresh, tastes much better. Bang, straight on your food, you can have it that night. That's the way to go.
And final question, What was it like being in the movie Save Your Legs?
Save Your Legs was great fun. We filmed it in India and I love cricket, so it was about cricket, but I did get very, very sick. And I had 4 or 5 days where I was pretty much sitting on the toilet the whole time. And then I had run out and I'd do a scene and do the filming and then I'd run back onto the toilet and sit there kind of feeling very sorry for myself. So I have some pretty mixed memories of making that film, but I did it with a lot of my friends, so it was good fun. Thanks so much for your questions, guys. They're really, really great questions. It sounds like you've really grasped the concepts of the film. And look, it is important to not fear sugar. You can still have a little bit of it every now and again. Certainly don't fear fruit. And it's important because these food, they do affect your body, your mind, your emotions. It's a very fat, powerful thing. It's like putting petrol in your car. If you put the wrong petrol in your car, the car's not going to run properly. And you've got to think about that with food as well. That's what food does to you. It's very, very important. So good luck with it. Spread the message, and make sure your dad stops drinking that iced tea as well. See ya.